Well, I'm muted.
Okay, Adelaide would have come, not proof. Okay, for Australia. Sorry about that. Oh, we have a very professional camera filming us now. The game has started, so Orcas is attacking the Australian basket.
We have now Colombian blue, Australian white, and we're underneath the basket of the Colombian, and we have one of the Colombians really fighting with the goalie. That's a very strong attack, but the other system, Federico, was very well defended from the one. We're being filmed here.
The Australian center attacking now, getting out.
Well done, because a very was really dangerous attack. And let me remind you that all of these players, or at least 90% of them, were the national players that play in the championship in Graz, in the World Cup, in the World Championship, and Colombia won the first. So now it's goal.
Next to the basket.
Yeah, this is the.
It's very, very risky.
From this side,
no one
was
there.
Yes, that was a miss. That was a mistake by the Colombian player, because it had been in, and now it's in. And made it good. So first goal, primer gol para los chicos de Orcas. Estaba diciendo que más o menos 90%, si no son todos los chicos que estuvieron jugando también en el campeonato mundial en Graz y que ganaron el primer puesto, ¿verdad? Entonces estamos viendo realmente a los campeones del mundo. We're watching the champions of the world in underwater rugby playing against the Australian team. So that's, you know, they're the favorites, I would say. They won a Champions Cup also last year. Let's see
how Australia is. Okay, so there is a free throw now for Australia for holding. And again, the team who is leading, who is potentially stronger, is making fouls. So this is, I find very interesting, because in quite a few of the games, the team who's ahead, the strongest team, is making more fouls. So
fouls, you mean?
Yes.
I mean, okay.
They're getting a lot of free throws against them. The Orcas, the women before, we also had Langen as well. They got a lot of free throws against them.
Do you see there was a common foul,
No, just the holding, pushing.
Okay.
Common easy fouls, maybe also because the referees watch out a bit more for the team who's winning, because they have an advantage. Okay, so now we have an attack on the Colombian basket.
But it's been tackled away by one of the Colombian players. They are now in the surface, and the ball is in the hands of the Colombian players. They are now in the counter attack, and it looked that it could be... Wow, great save by the goalkeeper. That was a very fast sprint, but the next Colombian... This is Daniel Arias. You can see he has injured his knee in the last EuroLeague game. In Colombia, in the last tournament they had, he cut himself and he didn't know he was going to play. So now we have 2-0 for Colombia. Those counter-attack are deadly.
So
I mean,
the Australians are fast, but Olga's really, really fast. And that was, again, an attack on an empty basket that was saved really last minute.
See, but really, I mean, good job by the goal. The problem is when you come so quickly. What? Oh, again, I mean, then the goalie cannot really lay good on the basket, so then the chance that the next attacker comes and do the score is a bit higher. But anyway, but they're fighting well.
Now the goals are a good settled in a pretty good defending position, and rolling on the goal.
We can see that there's some chaos in the Australian team, and now it's a goal on the side, and it almost, you know, the goalie almost didn't move. The Colombian game is really fast. And I think the Australians still are trying to catch up and to be in position on time for our ball to stop those counter-attacks.
And now it was three times in a row that there was a goal, but otherwise twice as well that it was almost a goal on an empty basket. Very last, just by a hair, the save. And let's see how the game keeps on evolving. We're at 3-0 for now.
Entonces los chicos de Colombia están jugando muy bien, muy rápido, hacen unos contraataques muy rápidos que los australianos están teniendo problemas para frenar y casi, bueno, han hecho goles casi con la cesta vacía, digamos que el portero ha bajado justísimo, pero bueno, no estaba bien puesto, bien acomodado, y el siguiente atacante ya lo ha podido convertir el gol. Así que estamos ahora nuevo en el partido y Australia está intentando atacar, pero bueno, de vuelta, we are in a counter attack and... That's an empty basket again. I think the Australians, if I would say, okay, time out, let's regroup, let's see, let's be maybe a little bit more defensive, although attack, you know, the best defense is attacking, you know, but so quickly or so fast like the Colombians are, they need to be a little bit more guarding, I think. What do you think, Lisa?
Maybe they know that they don't have a chance against Orcas, or they're trying to do, they don't play as offensive as possible, and okay, we know we're going to get scored on, and let's try to do something else and try to attack ourselves, but they were not rolling enough in defense. Now there was no one. There was the defender caught the Orcas by the leg, but there was no goalie going down.
They are not doing the gestaffelt. How you say that in English? They
roll back.
So now, right now, they're like, okay, lesson learned. I mean, they're a little bit. Okay, no, not lesson. What I was saying, the Colombians practiced that shot a lot. Actually, the last Champions Cup, one of the goals, the second goal was a score like that by Samuel Gaviria from about 1.5 meters above the, and they practiced that a lot. But they were better. What I was saying before the goal happened, that the Australians were placing themselves already 2-3 meters before. And so we're almost catching up with the counter-attack. But
so now the goals took a timeout. So now we saw that the defender rolled back, but the goalie didn't. And the defender didn't realize that. He looked up a bit at the beginning and thought somebody would go down, but they didn't.
Yeah.
That's too bad when this happens. It's very
I think, you know, if I consider how I would deal with it, if we have to play against a team like that, I really know that, of course, trying to move the ball and attacking is better than being just complete defensive, because then it's very tiring when you're all the time doing, you know, up and down. But they are super fast. So I would say, if that would be my team, I would say, well, you know what, let's make sure everyone have enough air to be in position for the defending. And then let's try, of course, to get the ball and then go to their side, but don't do any risky things, because the counter attacks are just.
But anyway, you know you're going to lose.
Comparable.
So what do? You keep on defending.
Yeah, because that's
the whole
a way.
Half time and defend and defend and defend and then.
Well, no. But I don't say all the time, but they are not really paying a lot of attention on being in position, and it would be a good practice maybe for the other games as well, and maybe try to equals a little bit more. I'm not. All defending is not also a good thing.
No,
I'm completely with
roll
you.
Back a bit
but
more,
they should roll a little bit more and concentrate on that, because right now what they can do is just make it more difficult for Colombia to score. And by doing that, you need to defend more. The problem is a very tiring game. When you're defending all the time, it's just exhausting after that game. Anyway, what do you think, audience? What would you tell the Australians they could deal with just a strong team? Christian, are you there watching? Or anyone else?
Certain, maybe.
He likes always just to share his thoughts and opinions. I like it. Okay.
I mean, we had a prognostic by...
Australia, what would you say your team? Colombianos. Bueno, los chicos de Colombia, la verdad, tienen una táctica muy pulida, muy trabajada. Hace 12 años que están trabajando para este momento, entonces... Realmente son el favorito, son el equipo más fuerte, están en control, saben exactamente lo que hacen, cada uno resuelve la situación y está en la posición que debe estar al momento que tiene que estar. Entonces, bueno, el que está en problemas es Australia, porque, bueno, tienen que realmente ajustar y no cometer ni un error. Y tienen que estar defendiendo un poquito más y como que no están llegando a tiempo, no se están concentrando en la defensa.
It's a free throw, now there was a free throw for Australia, and I think it was called off again by the deck referee. I guess what happened was that the 2-meter, 3-second rule was not respected by Orcas. There's again a free throw for Australia.
I didn't know what was the fall.
I think there was first a free throw for something, and then it was again stopped, but Orcas got the ball. I think that they had to redo it because Orcas didn't respect the 2-meter, 3-second space.
Yeah, for anyone that is watching and don't know the rules, for a free throw, the person that is doing the pass after the ball in position cannot move and have to do a pass before he is able to move, and it has to be within 3 seconds, and everyone else, the other team, needs to be 2 meters away at least.
There's a referee ball now.
Yeah.
And we got some feedback from Julie in Australia. So in Australia, the pools are really big, actually. They usually play in 450, 5 meters deep pools and longer pools as well. So for them, it's the first time they play. That's what you're saying, that they play in very short pools. The first time they do that. So
Julie, yeah, I remember that the Colombians used to have the same problem, but because they used to have super huge pools, and then when they would come here and shut short pools, they wouldn't cope with the speed of the game. So what they did eventually, and I don't know if that could be something for you, is to build a wall. So they really, they had a 30 meters pool, and now they have 215 meters. So I don't know how big is the pool in Australia. That could be maybe a solution.
What the orcas do, they have a small, they put a short wall inside the pool, and they adapt it to the pool they will be playing in the next tournament.
This is a wall that Camilo Diaz designed. If you call Australia need it, he can give you the plan how you can do it. So that could be maybe a solution, because they had the same problem. They could not cope with the speed. The game they had was much slower because they were used to larger pools. Anyway, let's go to the back to the game. We have now the orcas trying to attack, but look, we see all the white team underwater. Ah, that ball just got lost. I mean, they were all of them defending, doing a great job. They recover. You can see they're more physical in the Australian. It's like they're willing to have the ball. You have to see the tension in the body. It's a bit better there than at the beginning of the game. And they're still 2 meters away from the goal, but they're recovering, losing the ball. The next Colombian has it, and now they're right under the goalie.
5 seconds left, and there is
5 seconds less, and I think it's the end of the game. Great defense. Great job. Now they are defending.
It got way better. The last 3 minutes, and that's the last games, it's always been like that. The first halftime until 6 minutes, but the first 6 minutes, it's a disaster for one of the teams, and then something happens, they take a timeout usually, and then they start playing really different. Yeah.
Well, you know, I mean, when you're not used to play, this is the first time the goals come here, right? And so I don't know how many of the team playing in the national team that went to Graz, and already maybe, I don't even know if Australia got to play against Colombia, but when you have all these new teams, and the Colombian style is so different. It's so different. Even if Australia has some Colombian players that have been developing the sport there and maybe bring a little bit of the technique and tactic of the Colombians, it's not the same when you have, you know, the whole Colombian team. And also the Australians are developing the sport. They're more in the beginner size of the equation, right?
So it's true.
That's all. Then the capacity to adapt, the speed up, the nervosity of the cap. There's so many factors, you know. And
they have also a lot of experienced players, like some Colombians who who are playing in Australia. But no, there is a few players who are in Graz this summer, and I know that the goals are doing a lot of training, specific physical training, specific underwater rugby. Let's see how the second half goes.
Yeah, Julie's written that they have walls as well there, and the pools are like 5 meters deep, and that's also a big difference here, 380. This is 1.20 meters. This is at least 1.5 fins stroke that you need more to get in 5 meters. So actually, this should be an advantage for you, Julie, because when I'm used to play in deeper pools and you have the shorter ones, then you're faster down, and it takes you one stroke.
Yeah, but the opponent is also faster.
Colombians in the equation. I was just saying in general, the problem is now the length.
Okay, so they had 3 male players in Graz of the goals, and Hannah back here was also playing in Graz. No, but the game got better now in the second half. And
a ver, Colombia, que no los veo en el chat, que siempre me... que aquí salta, ¿viste? Se mueve el chat más rápido de lo que puedo leer. Están jugando los chicos muy bien. Y bueno, es el primer partido de la Champions contra Australia. Están ganando 5-0. Y ahora para comenzar el segundo tiempo. Están jugando en azul. Están teniendo, han hecho muchos goles de contraataque. Están dominando el juego. Y bueno, están haciendo el juego que conocemos de ellos.
So we get so heads up for being two women commenting. Like the fourth.
Laura, gracias. Sí. And Beate is also here. I mean, actually, right now is Beate, Lisa, Annika, I, and right now is Bob.
What, so the two games?
We are outnumbering him. And Thorsten is going to come maybe later.
I think he will compensate for the amount of talking with it.
Okay, Bob has now time to go take pictures and the selfies, and also something he likes. So, taken and started, and they call, well, that was quickly. I mean, they both got at the same time
they're,
to the ball.
They
and
have
the
some
Australian
very fast players, Australians. And
number one,
Freddy Corrales, who was training the women's national team.
Ah, well, okay, he's Colombian.
He's Colombian.
But because I was wondering, you know, the chest, it was like looking into like a mirror.
It's not, so a, it's not a genetic thing.
So we are now in the middle of the pool. They are a bit on the surface. It's a lot of pulling. And let's see, that ball was recovered by the Colombian team. And now they are in the counter-attack. And that's immediately, well, now it's I think it's Rembert alone on the close corner trying to pass it to the other side, but it was, now we had four defending. Great job from the Australians. I mean, now they are more there. I mean, they're probably, they could, you know, recover and get more the timing and the pace of the Colombian team. Now they recover the ball, they're trying to bring on the other side, but Colombia is forechecking. As Federico recover the ball, trying to find, very weird that he doesn't have any player. Most of the time, that's what I was saying, the Colombians are always in position, but that did not work well, and he lost the ball, but he was for a long time alone, and then three Australians were on him. And we can see the free throw, apparently, because I think he threw the ball and he was holed, right? I mean, so
yes, I think he did.
Because of that.
So both women, actually, from the goals are playing on the goal. It's interesting that it.
Ani, Daniel Aris está jugando con la rodilla vendada. Y gol. Sorry, Lisa, you want
to
say
something? No, no, the two goalies that were now in the water from Australia, there was two women.
Okay.
So they were switching and...
Yeah.
I know for playing in the Czech League against men, they will usually wait until a woman is on the basket and one is defending, and then they will attack because they won't go against the big guys.
I know, no, but the Colombians are not there. They don't care.
No,
they care. That's a good thing. You know, they don't discriminate. They attack everybody.
They can attack. They attack.
Okay.
So Ricardo Iriarte attacking from.
Do you know
what was the goal? No, that was just behind the basket.
Oh, that's too close. I mean,
that was very close. It was.
Yeah, I think that they are relaxing a little bit because they are in control of the game. So. But Australia knows what they're doing as well. I mean, they have experienced players, as Lisa said before.
And it was a bit, a lot of people were surprised actually in Graz in summer, like they didn't expect the Australians to do well. And I knew they would be fast and good, and if you had, people had been following them a bit, their games and their league, their championships, you have known they're fast and they're better, and so they just go.
And another goal. Can you hear us?
Is it just one person who cannot hear
away?
Us, or is it everyone?
All right. Put it closer to your mouth. Please have the microphone.
Yes. I think it's just one person. Yeah, they can hear us. Maybe put your sound higher if you can hear us. A bit louder. Okay, Orca's attacking again.
We have three in a counter-attack. Fede Londoño, Daniel Arias, ahí lo ven con la rodilla vendada. Sí, tiene que tener cuidado, pero bueno, por lo menos aunque se puede nadar un poco, si no puede atacar. Y un
bueno,
gol.
Just
la verde, ahí. ¿Quién es este? ¿La mamá o el hermano que está, que veo en la cuenta de Juan José la verde ahí? Jacobo, ¿no?
Then here we had the referee switching on the basket and the attacker took the opportunity and scored on this gap. Here we have some everyone's favorite Italian babies shouting in the background. Yes, you can hear them. Okay, maybe switch to the underwater camera. Someone, if you can hear us, yes.
So now we have Oviedo, the captain, there passing on the other side on the close corner. The Australians are paying much more attention, being in position for the defense, and now we have one attacker. Of the blue team coming up, but they're passing the ball up, down, right, left, and apparently pushing without ball, probably in the area of the defender. I was not looking because I was following the ball, and the ball is moved very quickly in this game. So it's zero for Orcas.
For Unidad goals. But as we were saying, the goals now, they only, so to say, only got scored on twice in this halftime.
Yeah.
And there's only
perfect.
less than five minutes left.
Yeah.
So they really restructured. Yeah, they don't have now open baskets that often, and they got a bit more concentrated, I guess.
The whole family of Juan José Laverde is watching.
Ooh, just one, okay. Just the goalie there. The defender didn't see that the ball is on the floor.
Great, great job from Australia. I mean, it's now Colombia really needs to watch the attack and really position and move the ball much more. They haven't been even goaled into empty basket either. The forechecking has been better. So, well, we had an attack from the close corner. I couldn't see who it was.
There was again the goal on the goalie switch.
Sí, Benjamín, están mirando también ustedes. ¿Pudieron? ¿Quién fue el que metió el gol? No vi quién se metió en la esquina cerrada. ¿Pudieron ver? Couldn't see who was the player on the close side. And the water is already the ninth game, and the water got a little bit more dirty. I mean, it was clear earlier today.
Very important to shower before getting in the pool at night, but was stressed here as much as we did in Graz to keep the water clear.
So we have now the last 3 minutes of the game, and Colombia is attacking, and now they're coming from above, from the side. They just got the pass, but the goalie of the Australian team did a great job defending
she had the ball, she lost the ball.
And Manuel is coming, and Daniel Arias trying to make a score from the side, and even with that, such he had like 10 or 12 stitches on that knee. You know, that happened 2 weeks ago. So even though Daniel Arias is unstoppable, even with a knee as hurt that he has it, so.
No, not the goal. It was really, that's a problem also when you have a smaller frame player, especially women playing on the baskets. It's way easier to push the ball next to
through
them.
Through the side.
If you have a strong player.
Yep.
That's how it is. So 10-0 now. And now, ooh, again. 3-1. Just
and
the goalie.
Goal.
It was, I think, Hannah Barringer down at the goal. She had no chance, but her teammates should have been there with her. So.
You don't, I mean, they have such a technique, I mean...
Oh, no goal.
No goal. Okay, no goal.
No goal, free throw for
all right.
For
did
the goal.
Did we see what was the call?
No.
No, no contó el gol. Aparentemente cometió alguno de los atacantes una falta y no pudimos ver qué, por qué.
Throw pass was caught by one of the Orcas.
Yeah.
This is too bad when this happens.
Yeah, but they're very quick. If you pay attention, they're normally positioned on the side of the wall and they kick themselves on the side to get the ball.
No, in this case it was a wide pass.
The
pass was too far away.
So now we are on the other side, on the close corner. The Colombians are trying to attack. They're passing the ball, and Australia is in position, but the ball is still in position of the blue team, and coming from the side. And Daniel Arias and Juan José Laverde made the goal. I mean, great. Trabajo en conjunto de Daniel Arias y Juan José Laverde. Daniel como que atacó un poco al portero primero y luego le pasó el balón a Juan José y hicieron el gol entre los dos. El gol de tu hermanito, así. A ver.
Okay.
So.
Orcas attacking from the close corner.
Oh, the ball was mentioned to the side, and Oviedo didn't see it. They keep passing. There was trying to pass the ball between the defenders, but the defenders were clever enough to grab it.
And that was very risky as well, passing down to the defender just at the basket. That's always a risky move to do. It was just Ricardo defending the ball, passing to Hannah.
Great job. Great job by the Australians.
Swimming out. 20 seconds left.
And that's a shoulder a bit inside.
This is when you should get all your players on the water and really try not to get scored on. 8 seconds left.
I think they want to score the last score. And I think there was goal. So 11-0.
11-0 for
And that's the Orcas. End of the game. Entonces 11-0 para los chicos de Orcas contra es Unidive Gold.
So Unidive Gold,
right?
From Brisbane.
You pronounce it Unidive?
Unidive, Unidive. University?
Sí.
Okay, so I think now it is, what is 26, so it's 2:30 a.m. in Australia, in Brisbane,
I
so
don't know.
I guess good night.
It's just like a 9-hour thing where Julie is Brisbane, I think, is 9 hours.
It's 10, we switched. Sydney, Melbourne, everything is 10 hours from Australia.
Since yesterday, changed 1 hour to today?
I don't know, I think it's 10 hours.
No, we control because we had to do the chat yesterday with Yuli and I think it was, anyway, 9 or 10 hours. Is, and I think that later, exactly, yeah.
Yeah, so now it's time to sleep.
So, no, it's 8 hours.
No, it wasn't summer. Now they switched to summertime and we switched to wintertime, so that's 10 hours.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, anyway, it's late.
So I'm taking
it's
a break.
It's middle in the night.
I'm
so that's why
now.
We didn't see many Australians.
Okay, so Beate is leaving. I'm looking
Muy bien.
For someone to replace
What's
me.
The next game, Lisa?
Next game
Molde.
Is Molde against
Zurich.
Zurich, men's game. Again from Group D. And I'll look for someone to replace me. I need a break.
Okay.
Thanks for listening.
We have now a few minutes, 5 minutes until the next game. We are changing here. Women power here in the Champions Cup, these first hours of commentating. So, do we have now people from Norway watching? And people from Switzerland? Jemand in der Schweiz, das schaut gerade, dass die Männer von Zürich spielen werden. And Norway, I wish I could talk a little bit of Norwegian. We have about 170 people watching. This is the first day of the 31st Champion Cup. And we have this year 23 teams all together, 13 teams, males and 10 females. Let me name you the players. We have lists that have been given, and these have been given a few weeks ago, so if it was a last minute modification, I sadly don't know, but we have Molde, number one, Bert Inge Pettersen, two, Jakob Laramer, four, Even Bjørnerem, five, Even Søvik, six, Jürgen Uvestad, seven, Iver Bjørnerem, eight, Uven Nius, 9, Per Sobakle, 10, Matthias Vassen, 12, Geir Magnestrand, 17, Leif Savik, I'm reading here, 24, Hernan Hansen, and 33, Niak Nordahl. That's from Molde. And then we have a Zurich, let me find, then we have number 2, Hannes Puschel, 3, Marcel Feta, 4, Anwar Ouraki, sorry if it's French, I don't speak French, 5, Christian Anna, 7, Matthias Dufour, 9, Patrick Schumann, 12, Martin Wölny, 15, Nils De Bruin, 17, Mark Drexler, 18, Michel Müller, 24, Dominic Peter, 43, Xaveri Onotsku, 54, Walterville, 73, Daniel Jussen, and 84, Frank Trettin. Okay, so we are now waiting. Mm-hmm.
So, hello everybody, guess who's back?